Okay, and we're back to day two of our aging research and drug discovery meeting. And to introduce the day, I have our Dean of the Faculty of Health and Medical Sciences here at the University of Copenhagen, Ulla Wewer, who will say a few words. Please welcome Ulla.
Well, maybe I can continue saying good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and maybe somebody around the world, good night. Well, anyway, dear guests, participants in this wonderful annual Aging Research and Drug Discovery meeting. As Morten said, I'm the Dean here at the University of Copenhagen, and it is really a great pleasure to warmly welcome you all. Welcome to also this old ceremonial hall at our university. And I would also like to say a special thank to all the local speakers, all the speakers out there in the cyberspace from all around the world. Thank you, everyone, for participating. Thank you also in particular to the Center for Healthy Aging for doing excellent and important research on aging and aging processes all the way from the molecule, the cell, to the society. And a very special thanks to Morten Scheibig-Knudsen and Daniela Tjania Bakula for organizing this event. And also, not only in this hall, but globally. This is what we want. We want to be seen, heard, and work globally together. And not at least because despite the pandemic and hereby traveling restrictions, all you global experts and thought leaders will now, yesterday and the next coming days, be able to share knowledge and perspectives in the coming days, focusing on tackling the challenges of aging through drug discovery and basic research. Thank you for your time and your commitment. According to the United Nations, the proportion of people aged over 65 now outnumber children younger than 5. Think about it. This enormous growth in the elderly population is posing a socio-economic challenge of societies worldwide, but also opportunities. It necessitates new sweeping interventions for age-associated diseases. We need to help each other. No doubt aging is the top of mind among local and national politicians, media, and the broader public, maybe even including myself. So in Denmark, we are of course familiar with several cases, headlines, and political reactions. We live longer, but we also ask ourselves, do we also really live well at an old age? Can we do something together to improve? And as societies, we ask, how do we look after and how can we improve the quality of life for the growing number of elderly people all over the world? Well, I guess we all agree that the answers are not straightforward. And a meeting like this, the 7th Annual Aging Research and Discovery Meeting, is a valuable occasion to share knowledge between academia, industry, and investors. We do still need more knowledge about how we empower people to live healthier, and we need more meaningful lives, but what does it mean? We still need knowledge that can form new prevention and health promotion initiatives for the benefit of the individual, the family, and the community's health economy. We need research, we need training, we need collaboration, including better integration of academia and industry. But due to the circumstances of COVID-19, this meeting allows us really to reach even further than when we start organizing the meeting. And I'm very, very proud that this year we have more than 1,300 registrations from all over the world. And as proof of the commercial interest, half of all the registrants are actually from different companies. This development is particularly exciting since we really want to be able to allow everybody to live a long and healthy life, happier than ever. So, welcome all of you to the 7th Aging Research and Discovery meeting. And I would really like to finally say how much I emphasize and how much I'm proud of how the Center here in Copenhagen for Healthy Aging participates. Well, being proud, I will tell you a few words because the Center for Healthy Aging does excellent interdisciplinary research, not only at the Faculty of Health and Medical Sciences, but interdisciplinarily also on aging and aging processes together with the Faculty of Social Sciences. We need to build bridges. Center for Healthy Aging contributes within education initiatives at both the pre- and the postgraduate level. We need to disseminate the good words. And the Center for Healthy Aging sets new standards for how a research center can collaborate with partners and stakeholders also outside our little university. There is no doubt that research and work at the Center for Healthy Aging will continue and I hope will be of great importance for the future. I hope that this meeting will also open up for lots of opportunities for collaboration across sectors between peers around the world. Once again, I thank you all for your time, your participation and commitment. And I'm sure that we will all have interesting talks and discussions ahead of us. The agenda speaks for itself. I wish you a continuous excellent meeting. Have fun. Thank you.